Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, I'm going to show you how to use guided access in iOS to allow a child to safely play with your iPhone or iPad. So let's say you want to hand off your iPad or your iPhone to a child to use, and you want them to stay in one app and not get in any trouble going into any other stuff or looking at your email or browsing the web or anything like that. You can do that using guided access. So for instance, say I want to set a child to GarageBand using the keyboard here, but I don't want them to be able to leave GarageBand. Matter of fact, I don't want them to be able to get into other sections of GarageBand either. So here's how you would do it. First, go to the Settings app, and under General, go into Accessibility. And under Accessibility, you want to scroll down to Guided Access and go in there. Then switch on Guided Access. You've got some options in here, like for instance, you're going to be setting a passcode for Guided Access so you can get out of it. And you can say, yes, use Touch ID as a way to get out of it as well. You can also set time limits so you can give them the iPad and say you can do this for 30 minutes and then it's going to shut off. And you can set options here of what sounds play when time limit is reached. And you can try out these options as well as this last one here, which brings up some shortcut settings when you triple click the home button. But I'm just going to leave them all off right now, and I've just turned it on at the top, and that's all I need to do. Now let's go back into Garage. So you want to go into the app and actually into the screen of what you're doing. Say you want to play a video, you might actually start the video playing at this point. Now you want to triple click the home button. So I'm going to hit it quickly three times. And that brings up guided access. At the bottom of the screen I have options. I can tap on the hardware buttons options and I could define which buttons I want them to be able to use. So maybe I don't want them to be able to change the volume, or maybe I do. So I can set those here. On the right I can set a time limit. So I can tell them, hey, you can only use the iPad for 30 minutes and then it's going to shut off. And then I don't have to worry about keeping track of the time. The iPad will shut off by itself. And you can even shut off touch completely, which say if playing a video you may actually want to do. So they can't actually use the screen at all. Now you see these little areas here. You can actually define these areas. I had some predefined from before, but now you can draw them with your finger. So I want to turn off all the buttons at the top of this screen here by dragging a circle around them. And maybe I even want to turn off some of this stuff down here so they can't get into trouble with that. You can drag these little dots to define the area. Now all they can do is change the instrument and use the keys on the keyboard. And you could define that any way you want. Maybe you just want to block off the stuff at the top of the screen like that. Now, as soon as I say start, which is at the upper right, I am asked to enter in a code. And now it started. And now that stuff at the top is turned off. They can use the keys at the bottom. And in order to get out of it, all that's needed is to triple click the home button, and it asks for the code. And then they come out of it here, and I can either resume at the top right or I can end. If I were to end, and maybe, you know, playing a video, maybe now I start another video, I can triple click and it would automatically start again. It's not going to ask for a passcode this time because I already did it before. So I'll triple click to get out of it and end it, and now I'm back into normal mode. So that's how you can secure your iPad and lock a child into a single app or even certain functionality within a single app using guided access.